order at Hallmark for the store nearest you.
Oh, what the hell fried the chicken?
Hi
there. In the early 21st century, an idea was proposed of a new geological record. The Anthropocene signifies the immense effect Homo sapiens have had on the planet. Some proposed beginnings of this new geological epoch being the Trinity Test in 1945, or the beginning of large human settlements 5,000 years ago in Sumeria. In this special broadcast, me and my colleagues will be outlining some of the immense effects humans have had on our Earth's geological record. We hope you enjoy the show.
Let's start with the most likely marker for the Anthropocene on the geological timescale. Concrete. Concrete is arguably the human race's greatest impact upon the geology of our planet. It extends upwards, downwards, and laterally across the entire surface. But what could concrete preserve? In August 2013, the paleontologist Graham Young from the University of Manitoba found a pair of pigeon tracks in a slab of concrete on a sidewalk in Halifax, Canada. And that posed the question, could this be classed as an Anthropocene trace fossil in progress? Well, the truth is, the long-term preservation potential of concrete is down to different people's interpretations of a future past, the present as imagined as a past seen from the future. On the one hand, concrete that forms our subway tunnels could theoretically be preserved as it's already underground. But the concrete that forms the tower blocks are only designed to last around about 60 years, and at the end of that lifespan, they get demolished. So in truth, we don't know how much concrete will be preserved, if any at all.
But concrete isn't going to be the only thing that could preserve in the fossil record. In 1945, the first nuclear bomb test was detonated in the Pacific Ocean, and between the years 1950 and 1963, over 500 nuclear tests were undertaken. Every single one of these tests released untold amounts of radioactive particles into the atmosphere. From there, they can circulate the globe and enter food chains once they descend to the ground. Once they enter the food chain, they can get into just about any living organism on Earth. That includes you or me. Every single creature born after 1953 will have radioactive particles in their bone structure as a result of the nuclear tests. Now, some of these elements will not preserve very long in the fossil record. Strontium, for example, will only last about 28 years, but there are some much more potent ones that the effects will be able to be seen for much longer. Plutonium, for example. Thankfully, we don't all have plutonium in us, but those of us that do will be able to see it in their bone structure for over 24,000 years. And that's just the element itself. The cancers that are left from it can be seen for far, far longer. Paleontologists of the future will be able to tell if we've been exposed to radiation because of the cancer in our bones as a result of these particles.
Years ago, the first jungle fossil domesticated in Southeast Asia. Now, we've been eating these little guys for centuries, stir-frying them, grilling them, turducking them. In fact, modern chickens are so morphologically distinct from their primitive ancestors that the leg bones of juveniles are twice the size of that of their jungle fowl ancestors. With their population last being estimated at 20 billion, they are the most numerous land vertebrate to ever walk the earth. In their stratigraphic record, the bones of domestic animals will make up a large brunt of the Anthropocene's stratigraphic record. What is this? Hey, inconspicuous masked gentleman. What is this?
What you've got here is an incredibly preserved technofossil. You see, technofossils are fossils made of minerals only native to the Earth through human technology. But the most common example would be this. It is plastic. It's the most widespread technofossil on Earth, mainly due to the erosion of plastic into microplastics, which circulates the Earth through ecosystems and oceans, and has created a thin stratigraphic layer across the entire planet, similar to that of the KT extinction event.
Oh, that's amazing. Say, can I have that back for scientific reasons?
No. Oh.